Hey everybody, what's up? Welcome back to another episode of Everything Kratom, the podcast about anything and everything. Kratom. Great to have you with us on this Friday morning, hoping all is well with you. Today, what can I say? We're back to space, I'm sorry. I love it. It's my fault, I know. So today I did want to talk about space one more time, but specifically, I wanted to talk about what factors would be influencing the Kratom if it was on its way up on a rocket ship to the International Space Station. We're gonna basically ignore all the laws, rules, regulations, all that aspect of everything. And this time we're just gonna talk about like what specifically is gonna be influencing the Kratom on the rocket and once it's there. So here's what I came up with, here's what I found. All this being a hypothetical scenario. Of course. So here we go. First off, there's going to be low air pressure. So of course, low air pressure, there's like little to no air pressure and then no air pressure as you go into space. So what happens is, interestingly, the boiling point of water actually gets reduced as you, like if you come to a point where there's like very, very, very little air pressure. And so when we're like going into space, interestingly, boiling point of water goes down, okay? Why does that matter? Well, there's water in plants. So if you've got kratom, that's gonna influence that. We're made of water too, yikes. But anyway, I'm assuming that that's not going to influence the kratom that we have. Maybe it's already dried, for instance. Maybe it's powder. Also, regardless, the air pressure is regulated, right? So it's going to be in a regulated place. If it wasn't, if we were bringing up kratom and it was like in the storage, you know, if we were like doing check bag or carry on and we're checking our kratom, then it's being subjected to something entirely different. So if the pressure drops, like the external pressure drops, that's going to cause the cells of the plant to expand and potentially rupture. So I'd imagine that would change a lot about the kratom. Then you have like oxidization. That's gonna be all thrown out of whack because think about it. It's either gonna be like exposed to no oxygen or then like all of a sudden it's gonna be exposed to a whole bunch of oxygen because you're going from like, you know, a vacuum or not a vacuum to a vacuum to not a vacuum. And it just depends on like what stage you're at. If you're checking it, if you're doing a checked bag, it's gonna be like, okay, no air. If you're bringing it with you, then it's gonna have air, but then like, I don't know, is it going to be stored somewhere else? Is the air in the rocket ship different from the air in the International Space Station somehow that's significant? How is that going to change the way it oxidizes? And that like affects the alkaloid profile, right? So then there's also just like, you know, environmental stresses on a plant can cause that to happen as well. Interestingly, when I was looking this up, one of the things I found was the fact that freeze drying it would be really easy. So you could store it forever, probably. okay, here's another thing. So I found that, interestingly enough, vibration and the G-forces are probably not going to mess with the kratom if it's packaged well. It seems like it's not going to have too much of an effect on the kratom if it's packaged well. The aspect of like little to no gravity doesn't seem like it's going to change our plant significantly if it's already ground up and in a bag and stored and sealed. Of course, none of this is 100%, I'm sure. Pressure and temperature. So it doesn't seem like the pressure and temperature is going to be changed too much to the point where the kratom is going to like change its being, you know, like astronauts got to go through a lot of G-force and everything for sure. But when it comes to like pressure and temperature, they're regulating the temperature. They have spacesuits on, sure. But the pressure that the kratom is going to be experiencing isn't necessarily going to like cause it to change what it's going to, you know, what it's made up of, for instance. Now, short-term radiation exposure. This is the thing that I was interested in a lot because I was assuming that going up into space, radiation is going to kind of like degrade the compounds or the alkaloids in kratom. And I think that I'm right because if you short-term, it's not going to be that bad. But over the long-term, this is one of the main reasons why we can't go to Mars, or at least not anytime soon. the amount of radiation you'd be exposed to simply in the time that it takes to get there and get back and have any time there would be significant. And basically there's not really necessarily the way around that that we have at our fingertips right now. So the plant's going to be exposed to radiation, and it seems to me that it's going to break down a lot of the alkaloids, or at least change the composition a bit. Now, of course, I have no idea how, but that's what I'm assuming. Now, once you get to the International Space Station, so the longer exposure that it has to radiation, it's going to change the alkaloids. We don't know how. But think about having like kratom stored up there for like, what would it be like if you stored kratom up there for a year versus storing kratom down here for a year? I wonder one thing in particular. I'm assuming the alkaloids would be broken down a bit up in space, but so will we. I'm assuming our bodies would get broken down too a little bit being up there for a year. And I know people have been up there for a year, but I wonder what kind of like change we experience if we took kratom after being exposed to the natural radiation that's up in space for a year, and then what that experience would be like, or how it would differ if our kratom also was exposed to that radiation for a year. Like, would we end up experiencing nothing if both of those things happened? Or like, if it's just us, but the kratom is from down here, you know, is the experience going to be like completely different and immense and totally spectacular, or totally terrible, too much, too little? I don't know. Okay, here's the last part, and this is the fun, ridiculous part that I wanted to end the week on. Toss and wash. You need to toss and wash, but you're in space. How do you do it? Is it the same? I guess it would be, but like, wouldn't it? It'd probably be a lot tougher, I would think, but I don't know. I mean, it would, think about how messy it would be. Actually, come to think of it, you, after a year of being up there, they you know, some new astronaut would come up to replace you, and they'd open they'd unseal the valve and open the door, and the whole inside of the interior of the International Space Station would be green. It'd just be like green powder everywhere. I didn't even think about that when I was like thinking through things and writing down notes of like, what would change, what would happen, what factors would we need to take into account. That's one of them, like cleanliness. You got to bring a broom or like a mop or something. I mean, it's tough to clean up kratom. So like, think about that. You open a bag and the powder is going to go everywhere, but it's not like it's ever going to fall down. Like, it's just, it's going to be in the air. So then you're going to have like consistent long-term exposure to kratom dust just in the air floating there. And you're always going to be like, I need a drink of water. Oh man. All right. That's about it. I won't go on, even though I could. Like, this is the sort of thing I love and I thrive on, is just coming up with these ridiculous ideas, like in scenarios, and then just thinking through them at length. Like, I'm still thinking through that one. I'm like, all right, how could we make that more absurd? Like, toss and wash. You got to have someone on one side and then someone on the other side. And the first person has to like almost like create like a kratom ball. I guess it would be kind of like those, you know, those like clear rice paper things that people are always talking about and putting kratom in instead of toss and wash. You could chuck one of those across the room and it'd like float around and someone could scoop it up. But I don't know. For some reason, I feel like it'd be a lot harder taking kratom up there than it is down here. And it's already hard down here, but at least I know with gravity where it's going to end up eventually. So, you know, that's where the mess will be. Okay, everyone, have a great weekend. Enjoy your Friday evening. We will be back on Monday morning. Talk to y'all then. Bye-bye.